Hello, Kush Kumar. How are you?
I'm good.
Nice meeting you. We are from dreamaboutsports.com. Can you tell us your background, your family and schooling?
I started when I was 8. I started playing sports when I was like really young. And yeah, I am basically from Dhampur. It's a small town in Uttar Pradesh. And from there, I shifted to Delhi and I studied there for 2.5 years. Then Indian Squash Academy offered me to come here and play for them. So after training in Delhi, I thought it's a good opportunity to should go to Chennai and train with the national coach and the Malaysian coach, Meza Maniam. So I said, okay, I'm interested in coming. So I shifted to Chennai and I'm really enjoying it here. After I come here, I learned like so much about the squash and they told me how to change my game and they helped me really a lot. I'm in my fitness and everything. They're sending me abroad for training and tournaments.
What got you started into squash?
At my club. I had a club like in front of my house, so I started playing there.
So, I mean, any of your family has a sports background?
No one.
At what point did you actually think you can actually play for India?
When first time I played at Nationals in Chennai in 2006 or 7, I don't remember. And I was unseeded and I won the Nationals. So I thought if I'm unseeded and I'm not training properly, and I was just, at that time I was just used to just play for fun, and I won Nationals, so my interest, I was like, I want to win more tournaments, my interest went up and I started playing more, I started training hard. So I thought if I'm winning a national, why don't I should apply abroad for like tournament, I should participate in international tournament and prove myself. So I thought that.
Oh, brilliant. So you've won many national titles and also you've gone abroad to win Malaysian juniors and other junior tournaments there. So can you share a few of your experiences from those tournaments?
Yeah, I have won a few tournaments. I have won Malaysian junior, Penang, and I have won the Scottish junior. In British 2009, I lost in the finals, yeah. And I have won Asian championship. So I'm really working hard, and like recently I played an Asian junior championship, 2 weeks ago in Iran. And against the Pakistani, I was 9-6 up in the fifth game, and from there I lost. That was a bad experience, but I learned a lot from there. Like I shouldn't lose in my future from that point. So I'm working on that.
Oh, brilliant. And what is the biggest accomplishment till date?
I have an Asian Youth Games gold medalist in last year in August in China.
Oh, brilliant. And what's the ultimate one? What are you dreaming of?
I'm 18 years old right now, and I've got I played a selection like 2 days ago for Asian Games, which will be in Korea in September. Mm-hmm. So I'm the youngest player in the team, and I got into the team, so it's like really good. Will be a good experience if I'll go and play in Korea for my country.
Oh, brilliant! Are you already playing senior tournaments?
Yeah, I played few senior tournaments, but I didn't do really good. Really well. So just working hard.
So how is this leap from juniors to seniors?
It's really hard when you play a senior players, because they know about they know more about the scores and they have a good experience. So you have to stay with them and catch them and beat them. Really hard. You should believe in yourself. What you want to do.
Can you tell us more about your coach, please?
My coach, it's Cyrus Poncha and Meza Maniam and all the academy coaches. So for last 3 years, I've been working with Cyrus, sir, and he's I'm just working on my techniques and my front games. It's not really good, but I'm working on that. I'm in drops and all. So he's really helping me out, and yeah, he's helping me in my games also, when to play, what game to play, and how to play game plans and everything. So I'm liking it.
Oh, brilliant. So can you tell us more about your parents and their role in changing you as a squash player?
My parents, they live in Dhampur right now, and they really support me when I need their help and what to do in my future. They always tell me what you want to do in the future. I say, okay, I want to become a professional player and I want to play for my country. They were like, okay, you can go ahead. And whenever I'm in trouble, I ask their advice.
Oh, superb. So how do they react when you lose or when you win?
When I win, they're really happy. When I lose, they were like, what went wrong? How did you lose? And I was like, mom, see, it's happened it's a sport. Winning and losing doesn't matter. It's
brilliant. Can you tell us your daily routine? What time do you wake up and how do you start?
Yeah, in daily routine, when I go to school, I wake up at 6. And from I wake up at 6, then I start training at 6:45 to 9.
Yeah.
Then from 9 I rush to school. 9 to 4 is school. So I came back from, I come back from school and I have training started at 4. So then 4 to 6 is my training over here. And then I'll go and I'll chill myself in swimming pool and do cool down.
Oh, brilliant. So how do you balance your academics and sport?
Academics. I did really pretty good in 10th grade and I'm in 12th grade now. Hopefully I'll do well.
Well, you will. Thank you. And how do you set your goals and what are your short term and long term today?
My goals, I'm really working hard for World Junior now, which will be in South Africa next month on the 10th. So hopefully I want to do really good in that, and that this will be my last World Junior. So I'm really thinking of doing something really great. So I don't want to tell on the camera, and if I won't do it, then it will be painful for me. So yeah. I want to do really good in that.
So players would have many ups and downs, right? So where do you draw the inspiration from?
Like in 2 years ago, in 2011, I was a top seed in a Malaysian tournament and I lost in pre-quarters really badly. And after that, I was very upset in the... And after a week, I was playing an Asian championship. And I was very upset. I came back to Chennai and I told my coach, I'm not playing good. This is happening. I mean, like, how I'm going to win Asian championship? I don't think I can do it. Then they motivated me and I started training well and I went and won the Asian championship. It was pretty good. I mean, like, it's a sports. Ups and downs is always like keep happening in your life. You should never like underestimate yourself and think like, no, you cannot do this. You can just take a rest for a few days and again start training. That will be a better idea.
Super. Who's your favorite sports star?
And favorite sports star is Roger Federer.
Oh, brilliant. So do you have any injuries currently?
Sorry?
Do you have any injuries?
Yeah, I was injured for 3 months. I had a back injury, really serious injury. So I didn't play for 3 months before the British Open. I mean, I was injured for September, October, November for 3 months. I didn't play sport at all. And it was a really tough time I was going through. Yeah, so I don't want to get injured again.
So how did you deal with it? Is it the physio who was helping you?
Yeah, my physio is here, Aarti, and she helped me a lot. And I started doing yoga for that. She told me like you should increase your flexibility and stuff. So I did yoga for 2 months, and it helped me a lot. So like,
brilliant. Thank you. Thank you so much for your time today, and we wish win World Junior Championship again, and hope you bring lots of laurels for the country. Thanks
thank
a lot.
You so much. Thank you.